costs look like salaries. They look bigger than salaries.
We also need to determine if that consultant is also working for the government and they are earning a salary in the government, or are they purely private?
This is just the summation of the general feeling of Kenyans over the professional fees charged by medical professionals for services rendered. Fees that the government has termed as exorbitant and a stumbling block towards achieving the universal health care in the country.
Many of us are product of village harambees, and if you are not, I am one of them. The people who struggle to educate me cannot afford the services that they help me acquire. Without any persuasion, you will agree that there is a problem there.
You do not have to have money to choose to go to a private hospital. A private facility is available, and it is available for everybody.
The reality of the expense meted on Kenyans as provided in the Guidelines on Professional Fees gazetted in 2016 was brought to light following the case of a patient who was charged over 800,000 shillings for treatment she received at the MP Shah Hospital in one night. Even after she succumbed, her body could not be released to the family until the money was settled in full. A matter that caught the eye of the board, which upon investigation found out that over 400 shillings was the consultant's fee. According to the 2016 guidelines, it will cost you between 3,600 shillings and 7,500 in consultation fees if you are to require the services of a specialized doctor. This being a key factor in which the board is now seeking to have the maximum fee reduced by at least 20%, with the Kenya Medical Association warning against such plans.
We think the process is being rushed, and we do not understand why it is being rushed, and there has been insufficient participation by the professionals themselves whose fees are being discussed.
Now, the committee that I chair, the Constitution Implementation Oversight Committee, is also engaged in another exercise of doing away with the minimum scale of fees.
However, the reduction of the fees has aroused debate as to whether this will make health services affordable for every Kenyan. Kioni insisting that this is just a tip of the myriad of issues the government is dealing with in the health sector in a bid to make health services accessible to all. Raquel Mugai for Citizen TV.